A very good morning to all. Looking at important headlines from the Hindu newspaper for 20th June, on the front page you have, panel will study the one nation, one poll issue. So 11 parties including Congress, DMK, BSP, Trinamool Congress and AAP, Aam Aadmi Party, skipped the forum meeting the Prime Minister had convened with other political parties. So, at the end of this party, it was decided that the committee will be formed by the Narendra Modi-led government to prepare a roadmap for one nation, one election. So, this was the issue in the last term too, which the Prime Minister wanted to implement. That was that there should be simultaneous elections. So, one nation, one poll is same as simultaneous elections. Simultaneous elections means elections to Lok Sabha and legislative assemblies should take place simultaneously. Both elections are held once every 5 years. So, Lok Sabha election took place now in 2019, but assembly elections in all 29 states in the country and two union territories, to Delhi and Puducherry, have legislative body elections. So, these also have a 5-year term, but they are not concurrent. Means, if say Gujarat's 5-year term ends at one time, then UP's 5-year term may end in another year. So, they are not concurrent. So, what happens is the Prime Minister Narendra Modi had said in the last term too that what happens is that the government is always in poll mode. Poll mode in the sense there are elections going on, so you have to rally, you have to address various rallies across the country. So, if there is an election in some state, so you are concentrating on that state for winning in that state. So, governance is affected. Basically, the central government has come to power, it's a political party, like BJP has come to power. So, the executive has been formed, the ministers have been formed who are supposed to govern the country at the central level for 5 years. But what happens is BJP also contests elections in a way of explaining that BJP also contests elections in other states. So, whenever there are elections in a particular state, say in Rajasthan or for that matter in West Bengal or any northeastern state too, what happens is that the executives here, Prime Minister himself goes and rallies in those states. So, that makes it difficult to govern. You are always in election mode. That's what he means. So, this, and not just the Prime Minister, other ministers and other members of the political party too. So, that is why what they want, what is said, is that there should be simultaneous elections at the central and state level. But means if 2019 was Lok Sabha elections, then 2019 should also be elections in all states. All state legislative assemblies should have had elections in 2019. If not now, then by 2024. Means there should be one nation, one election. But then India is a diverse nation. We have a central government to Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha, the parliament at the center too, and we have a legislative body at state level too. There are state political parties too. So, in such a scenario, whether the central political party would be preferred at state level too, how would the voting to take place and how would people vote? That is a question which has been raised. But I think this time in the 2019 elections, we clearly saw that how people have voted for a particular party at the state level, because by polls and polls in some legislative assemblies also took place along with Lok Sabha elections. So, in that it was clearly evident that though BJP was preferred at the central level, at the state level, it is not necessary that people vote for the same political party. So again, this issue of one nation, one poll has been picked up and we'll see how it goes ahead. But then that's what another technical issue with this problem, with this idea, one nation, one poll, is that how would you go ahead if the government loses majority? Means, for example, you have simultaneous elections in 2024 all across the country. Somehow the term has been matched, or some government's term is terminated, or in some way initiation has been done. 2024 is simultaneous elections, means government which comes to power in 2024 at central level and in each state. They will be there for 5-year term. So now, if after 2024 in a particular state, if the government falls in 2 years, government loses its majority in the house in 2 years, then what happens? How will the new government be formed in the state? Because it's people's mandate. If people's mandate is no longer there with a particular political party, does not have majority in the house, then how can it govern? So it's constitutionally difficult to, constitutionally it cannot work. So that is an issue. But then there are simultaneous elections which take place, and there are suggestions which poured in when the issue was there earlier, that what can be done is that if a no confidence motion has been initiated against a particular government, say, you know, in a particular state, if no confidence motion is initiated against the government, then at the same time confidence motion should also be initiated. Means if that government falls, at the same time alternate government should also be voted for, you know, or so that confidence motion would also be there. Means if they have lost the majority, there is some other body, another group of political parties or a political party which has the majority. So only then. So then again, of course, the question is that if the first political party, if this is not possible, and if still the first political party does not have majority, then what? So of course there will be technical issues, but let's see. Panel is now going to study this. Then next is, PM's panel rejects former CEA's paper on GDP growth. This was prominently in news. Prime Minister's Economic Advisory Council has rejected Arvind Subramanian, who was former chief economic advisor. So he has published a paper in which he talks on GDP growth, how GDP growth has been inflated and stated, you know, the data has been inflated, so it's actually not as high as has been provided from 2011 to 2017. So that's what he has suggested in the paper, but PM's panel, PM's Economic Advisory Council, rejects this paper. It says it lacks rigor, won't stand up to scrutiny. Then this is regarding Muzaffarpur acute encephalitis syndrome death toll. It is continuously increasing now, 115 children have died here. Then on page 4, city page, here you have ozone pollution higher this summer. So ozone pollution has increased in Delhi NCR region this summer compared to last year. So this is an analysis for Center for Science and Environment Delhi. So you should know pollution due to ozone. It says when temperature increases, the rate of production of ozone also increases. It can cause fatigue, breathlessness and asthma. And here it is said that surface ozone is not a primary pollutant, but it is produced due to chemical reactions of nitrogen oxides and carbon monoxide in the presence of sunlight in atmosphere. Then on page 9, you have this coverage on acute encephalitis syndrome. It says plea petition in the Supreme Court seeks expert team to treat acute encephalitis syndrome patients. So we have seen the death toll on the front page. There was news that Muzaffarpur toll hits 115. So 115 children have died due to this, and it is said this is mostly children from lower socioeconomic background who were malnourished, and they went to bed without dinner, without a meal. So this generally results in, you know, encephalitis next morning and symptoms emerge. But then what is required is an urgent intervention. Dextrose dose can easily save them. This issue was prominently covered. Every year such incidents take place, and it clearly reflects the negligence on the part of the administration and lack of creating awareness among the people on this issue, which is resulting in deaths of children which could have easily been averted. So this editorial of 18th June in the Hindu, titled The Litchi Link, that is very important. You should know this issue. And this is UP site expected to get national importance tag. So this is an ancient site in Uttar Pradesh, in Uttar Pradesh Baghpat district. So it will be declared as a site of national importance. So this site is called Sadikpur Sinoli. It's spread over 28 hectares and it's of national importance. It is said it's largest necropolis of late Harappan age. Then on the editorial page, the first editorial is Beyond Mayday. So this is regarding Jet Airways case. So it says the Jet Airways case has takeaways from the bankruptcy code as well as for other airlines. So Jet Airways has been referred to National Company Law Tribunal now. So insolvency proceedings would be initiated now. So about the bankruptcy code and the airline sector in general, how it is framed. So because we have also the Kingfisher's airline issue, we have Air India, which is a major concern. So this is the issue covered in this editorial. The second editorial, deadlock in Libya. So this is regarding Prime Minister Al-Sarraj's peace plan. It says it will work only if the big powers help enforce a ceasefire. So this is in Libya. So Libya is also under a crisis now, political crisis. So this is covered here. And the lead article, what a 5 trillion economy would look like. So it says the economy must be evaluated in terms of how much it contributes to the ease of our living. So this is economically, we want to become a 5 trillion economy. That has been the target announced by Niti Aayog. So Prime Minister Narendra Modi has announced that India should become a 5 trillion economy by 2024. That is the target. So what a 5 trillion economy would look like is covered here. But it says the economy should not be validated in economic terms, but how much it contributes to ease of living. And the second article here is the forgotten funds. So it says the government must utilize cess proceeds and publish an annual account of how they have been spent. So cess is imposed, but then how is it spent? Like there is an education cess which was introduced in 2004 at 2%. In 2007, an additional 1% cess for higher education was announced, secondary and higher education. In 2019, a 4% health and education cess was announced. So all these cess amounts, how is it spent? There should be annual account and which should be published is what this article calls for. Then on the op-ed page, you have this coverage on Iran-US conflict. It says why an Iran-US conflict looks like a realistic possibility. So that is discussed here. And this is regarding water issue. It says the crisis in Tamil Nadu shows that we have a lot to learn about rainwater harvesting from our ancestors. So there has been a water crisis, the drought-like situation which was seen. So in Tamil Nadu also there is acute water shortage. Then on page 12 you have how Om Birla has now been elected as the Speaker of the Lok Sabha. And this is joint elections must not must. So this is what Delhi High Court had ruled in 2009. So ruling was actually on casual Rajya Sabha vacancies. So there were by polls to two Rajya Sabha seats which were being held separately. So this issue has been challenged in the Supreme Court by the Gujarat Congress, and it had come up before Delhi High Court in 2009. So at that time Delhi High Court had said that it was not mandatory to hold joint elections in the case of casual vacancies. So joint elections are not a must, has already been ruled in bipole elections by Delhi High Court in 2009. So this issue is actually different from the simultaneous election or one nation one poll issue. This is regarding by-elections for two seats which have become vacant. We discussed this yesterday. Two seats have become vacant in Rajya Sabha because of Amit Shah and Smriti Irani resigning from Rajya Sabha because they have one seat in Lok Sabha in the present election. So you can't be a member of both Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. So they are resigning from Rajya Sabha seat. So because these two seats both were elected from Rajasthan to Rajya Sabha, so if both these seats have become vacant from Rajasthan, by-elections would be held to fill these Rajya Sabha seats. So for these two seats, separate elections are being done. So at that time, Delhi High Court, when it was such a case came before Delhi High Court in 2009, it said joint election means both seats election should be together. Joint elections is not a must. Presently, Gujarat Congress has approached Supreme Court on this issue. Then on page 13, you have this coverage on car bomb which was used to target army patrol vehicle. So this is National Intelligence Agency asserting to. So it was third such attack in the past 4 months, which took place on the Pulwama, Arihal Pulwama road in South Kashmir. So it was first major attack after the Pulwama attack of 14 Feb 2019. So Pakistan had shared intelligence on this. So even Jammu and Kashmir governor, he says that Satyapal Malik, he says that it was Pakistan which reportedly shared intelligence on an impending militant attack in Jammu and Kashmir. So Governor Satyapal Malik said that it was duty bound to do so. And below you have US wants fair and reciprocal trade with India. So State Department of USA says that India is one of our closest strategic partners in the Indo-Pacific region, and what USA wants is fair and reciprocal trade. On page 14, you have UN report links MBS to Khashoggi killing. So this is Mohammed bin Salman, the Saudi Crown Prince. So UN report says there's credible evidence linking Saudi Crown Prince to the Jamal Khashoggi murder, which took place in the embassy. This was prominently in news last year. So he was a Saudi journalist, and he was killed in the embassy in Turkey, in Istanbul. So the UN report says execution of the dissident journalist was the responsibility of the state of Saudi Arabia. On page 15, business page, you have Banks Association tweaks inter-creditor agreement. So this was also a question in UPSC prelims 2019 on inter-creditor agreement, ICA. So Banks Association, that is Indian Banks Association, has tweaked the inter-creditor agreement that was framed by the Sashakt committee to keep it in line with the revised guidelines of the RBI on stressed asset resolution announced on 7th June. So it aims to align this with the RBI norms. So that's why ICA inter-creditor agreement has been modified. And this is Finance Minister holds talks with financial sector regulators on budget. So this meeting comes as growth has hit a 5-year low of 6.8%. On page 16, you have won't allow FDI in multi-brand retail, predatory pricing. So this is Commerce Minister Piyush Goyal, who has urged small retailers to spruce up shops and avail center schemes such as Mudra scheme. So it says that FDI and multi-brand retail would not be allowed, but even the small retailers have to, you know, expand themselves, have to take advantage of various schemes which the government provides. And on the last page, you have cancer cell detection dots developed from coal. So this is a team of scientists in Assam who have developed a chemical process that turns dirty coal into biomedical dots to help detect cancer cells. So here you can see this is called CQDs, that is carbon quantum dots. So these are futuristic materials whose demand is on the rise. So you should know about CQDs. This is an important keyword, carbon quantum dots. You know, they can be these can be produced from cheap, abundant, low quality and high sulfur coals. So these are carbon based nanomaterials, that is size of less than 10 nanometer. So these are the important headlines. For detailed coverage of current affairs, you can visit our website aashar.com. So we have a separate course here too, you should know, in the current affairs section on aashar's website. So this is the current affairs section. So here we have a separate course for current affairs detailed videos. So the details of that course is provided here, and detailed current affairs video sample is also provided. So that is it. Thank you.